Sean Mullin. I am the writer-director of Amira and Sam.
What does it mean for you to be a part of this year's Raindance Film Festival?
Oh, we're super excited. We are getting ready to release the film in the United States in January, and so we're kind of just starting our festival run, so we're really excited to be here.
Can you give us a quick synopsis of the film?
Yeah, it's a love story about an Army veteran and an Iraqi immigrant in New York City. They kind of have this unlikely romance and kind of gets put to the test when Amir is faced with deportation. And it's funny. It doesn't sound too funny, but it's pretty funny. And that's what it is. I've got our actress here, Dina Shahabi, who you'll talk to in a second, and Martin Starr is the lead. And we're really excited about the movie.
I mean, obviously, Martin's familiar to a lot of fans from things like Adventureland and Freaks and Geeks. Can you talk a little bit about how he came on board?
He just read the script, really liked it. He hadn't done a leading role yet before, and so he was kind of excited, and I think by the challenge. And so it was really great to kind of collaborate with him and Dina and the rest of the actors to really tell his story. So, I was in the Army. I was a captain in the Army in the United States, and so I had a lot of friends who were coming back from. Back from war and everything, and I wanted to try to find a way to tell a story about a veteran coming home that wasn't about him grappling with post-traumatic stress or any sort of PTSD. And so I came up with this premise where maybe he comes back from war, he's fine, but the country lost its mind, you know? And that's kind of a new take on the whole veteran coming home genre. There's no political dimension on purpose, but definitely you can read into anything you want. But really, I mean, these are big issues, you know, immigration and veterans and all this stuff, post 9/11, you know, New York. And so these are big themes. And so the best way to tell those, I thought, was in an intimate love story.
What are you hoping overall an audience takes away from the film?
I hope they take away that, I don't know. I hope they have a good time. Hope they enjoy it. Hope they see, hope we challenge perceptions, I guess. That'd be my number one thing.